Okay, welcome back to Advanced Photoshop once again, and this time we're going to do another project in 3D. We're going to be taking a two-dimensional image and making it into a three-dimensional object and exploring some cool things that you can do with that. And we'll be using the new extrusion tool in the 3D panel to do this. Let's open up the iPhone JPEG image in Photoshop. And in our layers panel, let's rename the background layer phone. I want to remove this blue background. So I'll go to my rectangular marquee tool and I'll select just a small portion of that blue background. And then I'll go to my select menu and choose similar. And it will select all the blue background. Now you may see that it's picked up a few of these pixels in my iPhone that are also that same color. So I'll hold down my option or alternate key and drag a marquee over those to remove those from the selection. There's a few more up there, because we want to make certain that only the background colors are selected. Next, I'll invert the selection by pressing Command-Shift-I or Control-Shift-I on the PC. So now only the phone is selected. Let's go to our 3D menu at the top, and we're going to choose New 3D Extrusion from Current Selection. And back in our Layers panel, you'll see that it has converted it to a 3D layer. You see the little 3D icon at the bottom of the bottom right-hand corner of our thumbnail. Let's increase the canvas size so that we have a little more room to work. We'll go to Image and Canvas Size. I want to make certain that the relative option is not selected, and I'm going to set the width to 8 inches and the height to 8 inches and click OK. And that adds some space to our image. In my 3D panel, I'm going to go to my phone object here, and then you can see I can rotate it, and you see we've created a 3D object. Let me close this panel here. You see we've created a 3D object from a 2D image. Of course, it needs a little bit of work, and we'll do that now. So in our 3D panel, let's click on the phone object and go to our properties panel. Make certain that the mesh option is selected, which it is by default, the little 3D star up here in the top left-hand corner. And let's set our extrusion depth to 80. Let me move this out of the way so we can see a little bit better. So now you can see how our phone is now much thinner than it was before because we changed the extrusion depth. Next, let's click on the cap button. And where it says sides, front, let's click that drop-down menu and choose front and back so that we have a backside to our phone. And in the bevel properties, let's set the bevel width to 7%. And the angle, we'll leave at 45 degrees. And now when we rotate our object around, you can see how we've kind of beveled out those edges so that they're kind of nice and round. see a more exaggerated view, you can move it to the side there, and you can adjust the width to see how it bevels like this. Now let's go back to our 3D panel. And we'll choose Filter by Materials. And we'll choose the front inflation material. I'll go to the Properties panel and adjust the properties for this front inflation material. The front inflation material is this front side of our iPhone. And we've got a, let's go back here to our 3D panel. You see that you've got a front bevel material, which is the beveled edge we just did, the extrusion material, which is the sides, and then you've got a back bevel and a back inflation material. So again, we're going to choose the front inflation material. I'll go to my properties panel for that. And you see you've got some default settings for this, for the properties, such as the shine, the reflection, the roughness, and so on and so forth. I'll set the reflection to 10 so that it's going to reflect a little bit of the light that we shine on it. Now I'm going to do a nice little trick. I'm going to scroll down here to the bottom of the properties panel, and you'll see a little label that says environment. And next to that, there is a folder. I'm going to click that little folder and choose Load Texture. And I'll go to where I have saved my files from Blackboard, and I'll find the lights JPEG image. And it's just some reflections or some what we refer to as bokeh, these little out of focus circles of confusion, just a little JPEG image. And I'm going to choose open. And what has happened is now when I rotate my object around, you can see that JPEG image reflected in the front inflation material, and it adds a great deal of realism. And back in our 3D panel, we'll choose the front bevel material, go to the properties panel, and I'm going to set the reflection to 100% so that it looks like it is chrome plated. We're going to repeat this for the back bevel surface. Back to the 3D panel, choose the back bevel material, go to the properties, change the reflection to 100%. Let's go back to the 3D properties again, and let's choose the phone extrusion material, go to the properties, and for the diffusion color, let's set that to black. Now let's make a nice composition with our object. I'm going to make this an ad for the iPhone. And I want to have the iPhone kind of floating above the ground in kind of a nice angle. So let me zoom out here just a little bit. And I'm going to go to my 3D drag tool. Let me pull this out just so you can see a little bit better here. We'll go to the 3D drag tool, and I will click to select the object, and then I'll move it on the Y axis so that it's floating above the ground a little bit. And then I think I'll rotate it at an angle. And you may want to rotate it towards your audience a little bit. I'll move my cursor over to the center of our widget, and I'll click and drag up to scale it up just so that it fills up the space a little bit better. And if you need to, you can adjust your camera view by going over to the widget over here in the lower left, and you can adjust the angle of the camera as you see fit. Next thing I want to do is create a backdrop for our camera. So I'll go to my layers panel and I will hold down the command key and click on the new layer button. By holding down the command key, when I create the new layer, it places it beneath the previously active layer. And on this new layer, I'm going to fill that with white. So I'll press Shift and Delete, or Shift and Backspace, and I'll choose white. Now that I have a background, I can see my shadow easily. And I want to adjust the lighting and the shading. So let's click on the 3D layer in the Layers panel, then go to our 3D panel, and let's click on Filter by Lights. And here is our one light. And I think it's best just to have a single light in this situation so we don't have conflicting shadows and the like. And I'll find the little widget for the light and I'll adjust it. I want to make certain that the surface of my phone is properly illuminated. So I'll adjust that as I see fit. I'm also paying attention to the shadow. How do I want the shadow to be viewed? I kind of want my shadow to be falling behind the object and a little bit off to the left-hand side. Now I may want to go back to my object here, click on that, and just move it up above the ground a little bit more now that I can see where my shadow is being placed. I'll go back to my light and click on the Properties panel. And I'm going to set the softness to 100%. Now you can set it to whatever you want, but don't leave it at zero. Otherwise it's just going to be too harsh. So you can set it to whatever you want. Well, maybe I'll just set mine to 50%, just so that it's maybe not too soft, but at the same time the edges won't be too hard. So about 50% would be fine. And now I'm ready to render my image once everything is set up the way I want it. Down at the bottom of the Properties panel, I'll click on the Render button. And then I'll wait a bit. Whenever you see that blue grid going across, that means your image is being rendered. And you can see how more detail, particularly in the shadows, is added with every pass. Okay, it's taken about 20 to 25 minutes for this image to render, but that is our finished 3D image. And all you have to do is click on layer 1 to turn off or to hide the ground plane, and you see your finished image. So send this one to me on Blackboard, and that completes our 3D lessons.